question of Sivam. Yes, you know, nowadays the biggest problem is here having little water for drinking, and that's the goal of our project. We are finding a way how to clean that polluted water and to use a natural resource.
This natural resource, named as zeolite, is the main thing that we use in our experiment. With this natural thing or mineral, we can cure our water from heavy metals. The zeolites are capable of removing most of the heavy metals from the water. In our main goal or aim was to prove that we can cure our water with something natural and that doesn't involve any risks for hazardous material.
In our experiment, we are using the zeolite cleanup zeolite, and we are using the property of this zeolite that is to absorb heavy metals from water and release positively charged ions in exchange.
Heavy metals, this part is maybe one of the most important parts in our experiment. For setting this, we firstly took a sample of water from area near Stromos, that is a small village in Provishti, Macedonia, a town in Macedonia, Provishti. And we compare the initial results from that water with the heavy metals that we have got in our lab here in our private reactor chemical plant. So these are the static amounts of heavy metals that mostly occur in water that is polluted. We took this and with certain amount of that water that we took from the polluted area, and with this we combined those together and made a solution of very polluted water that has a lot of heavy metals in it.
Now we come to the solution part and the experiment. First, we take the amounts of heavy metals and we measure them on a scale. We did it as precise as possible, and where it was needed, we used a spatula. After that, at the same time, we did some calculations, calculating their weight by using their molar masses and amount of substances.
Next step was taking each measured heavy metal and putting them in volumetric flask, each after each other. Then, in order to make a proper solution for further usage in this experiment, we added distilled water in every volumetric flask. When we were finished with making the solution from heavy metals in distilled water, we closed the volumetric flask. Then we waited some time and we took a certain amount of 100 milliliters of already prepared solution with heavy metals in distilled water, and we put that into a beaker that's 400 milliliters.
After that, the zeolite part comes, and we also measured the zeolite to 5 or 10 grams, and we prepared it for further use.
These steps are the most important ones for our experiment. Firstly, we took 2 grams, precisely measured 2 grams of zeolite, and we mixed with 400 milliliters of solution. Together, we put them into a beaker. We did the same procedure for 5 grams and 10 grams of zeolite because we want to show the results how we can cure our water with 2 grams, 5 grams, and 10 grams of zeolite. Then, when we were finished with this, we put for a better representation of results and better results, especially, we put the beakers one after another on a magnetic stirrer and waited for 1 hour to mix with the magnet.
After 1 hour, we should have separated the zeolite from the solution, and we did decantation and filtration. We did this 2 times because we wanted to get more clear results and analyze.
We wanted to clean the solution as clean as possible because we didn't want to get something that will
be different.
Yes,
from our
that will make problem in our solution results. Then we sent our wetland samples to Institut de Gama Zdravia, that is a small laboratory for chemical research and investigation analysis, yes, here in our capital town, Skopje, and we waited for our results.
After we got our results, we made tables and we represented our results, and in this table here are shown the left amounts of the heavy metals in the solution.
The initial one is 40 milligrams into 100 milliliters of the solution. As possible, as we can see, the left particles are the smallest into the left one, because we have here the small amounts when we compare to other ones. The results, when we got our results ready, we compare the initial condition of the solution with the zeolite with the final results that we have So we represented, for a better seeing of the results, we represented them into the percents. So we can as clear see how many percents of the heavy metals are absorbed. Here, I represented them graphically, so we can see in the lead, we absorb the most particles of the lead are absorbed with the zeolite, because also we can see as the amount of zeolite is higher, the absorption is higher. Mm-hmm. In 10 grams of zeolite, we can absorb almost, I can
almost
see 70 or 80% in total. For lead, we can absorb about 98 or 99%.
We also did the research about the zeolite, and we find out, not the zeolite, but the absorption of heavy metals in water, and we find out that the biggest number, the biggest amount of absorption of heavy metals is 95%, but with our project, we find out and we prove that almost 99% are absorbed, and this is pretty good, and
yes, we can see that it's the best way to blend the water is more water, because we need innovations like this in the future. So our conclusion about this project is that the mineral that we use in this experiment is the, I think, the best one, because it doesn't involve any risk, any chemicals. It already from, it's given from the nature, and we should use it. We should make more innovations like this in hope to have a brighter future. So thank you for your listening, and hope that we will see you in September.
I hope you enjoy it.